Hello and welcome. It's Bill Sklodowski and it's time for What's New Wednesday. Every Wednesday we do a quick tip for your iPhone or iPad. Something I hope you haven't heard before. Something new and different and cool and fun and all those things. So we're going to dig into today the emergency calling and emergency ID functions. Now, there's a lot with emergency information that you can put into your phone. And I think we're going to get to that. I want to get to that on a future iPhone Friday episode, because that's a little more meaty, a little more, you know, material there to cover. And I'd like to give it a plenty of time. But for today, since it's kind of a quick tip thing, I thought we would talk about the emergency calling function and how you can access that quickly, and then how to get to emergency information for somebody. So, of course, this there's a couple of ways that this could be used. You know, if you have a problem, you know, if you have a medical emergency and somebody should come to your aid, whether it's, you know, EMTs or a friend or something like that. If you have your iPhone handy, you can put information on there so that, you know, if you're not in a condition where you can answer, kind of important that people have information about you. So anyway, that's what this is all about today, how they can get to that. And on the other hand, of course, if you should come across somebody that needs assistance in some way, then maybe this will help you as well if that other person has an iPhone and has done their thing. So might be a good thing to spread around your friends, you know, the ask if they have emergency information set on their phone and, you know, that it's something that we can get to. All right. Now, because of the way that this all works from the sign-on screen of your phone, I can't really show it to you on my live iPhone because it's on, well, I can show it to you here and then I'll have a picture of what you will see, a screen capture, you know. But I can't show you on this since you can't, well, never mind, you'll see what I'm talking about in a minute. So let's dig in, shall we? So for starters, if you are, and I wanted to clear that so I can, you know, show a bigger picture of my phone. Normally, when your phone, of course, is off, you know, it's if I turn it off, you know, asleep, whatever. When it comes back to life, and I have fingerprint ID, so I'm going to use a finger that's not one of my ID fingerprints. So if I were to tap the phone, it's going to come back to life with the fabulous partner there, Miss Lori. Enjoying some nature prior social distancing, having a great time with my partner there. Oh, and see, it went blank again. So anyway, you know, somebody taps on that. And of course, across the bottom there, it says press home to unlock. And of course, if I have my fingerprint ID or my face ID for the newer phones, of course, it's going to unlock. Somebody finds a phone, you find someone with their iPhone, someone finds you with their iPhone, of course, they're not going to be able to do that. And if they try, of course, it's going to go to that screen, right? And here, I have that one set for us. It's going to go to that screen, and you've probably seen it, because when your phone starts up after it's had an update, or if it's been turned off all the way, it may require you to put in your passcode. Not just to have it see you or use your fingerprint ID, right? I'm sure you've seen this 100 times. Now, the other important thing about this is that when you do that, and let me bring it up on mine, when you do that on the newer ones, here, let me go back and show you what I've got on mine. On the newer ones, see right down there on the bottom where it's, you know, normally I would be putting in my touch ID, but it also has an emergency button, right? So even if the phone is still locked, anybody can walk up to it and tap the emergency button. And here's what it looks like. Hang on, I'll jump over to the next screen here. And it looks like this. From there, someone can make an emergency call. They can dial 911, they can do any number, you know, whatever the local number is, that sort of a thing, okay? So that's cool. They can get help for you, or you can get help for someone else. And then down at the bottom there, see in the red where it says medical ID. And again, even if the phone is still locked, you can still tap on medical ID and you will see something that looks like this. Now, this one came from the Apple website, so I'm pretty sure Michael Cavanaugh isn't even a real person, so don't worry about that. but it shows some important medical information about them. You know, if they have any known conditions, allergies, medications, blood type, height, weight, things like that. Important stuff for paramedics and EMTs to know should they find somebody in need of care and that person can't give them the needed information, right? So that is a great, great function there. And again, it's something that you can view on a phone without that phone being open or without that phone being locked, is what I should say, okay? Even if the phone is locked, you can still get to that information, you can still get to the dialing information, etc. And all you have to do on it is press on that. Oh, let me get back to it here on my phone so I can show it to you. All you have to do is tap on that emergency button down there at the bottom where you would normally, on the same screen where you would type in your passcode, okay? So there you go, I'm gonna do that. Now, by the way, on there, and when I, you know, when we get around to talking about that emergency ID and all of that is in settings under health. Maybe I can jump over to that. Hang on 2 seconds here, let me try something. If I do this and I do iPhone, and there you go, look at that. It worked pretty well. Same thing, if we were in settings and you scroll down to the health entry, all right, where did it go? I know it's in here. I was just looking at it a minute. Not the emergency call, not the SOS. There it is, the health one. And you tap on that, all right. You can, right there where it says health profile, you can add in your own, all right? And if you have to edit it, you can, you know, type on edit and edit in there. And so if you haven't done that, probably a pretty good idea. We're not going to get into all that right now because that's, again, like I said, there's a little bit more information in there, but you could put in the medical ID and, you know, if you want to be able to have somebody's phone come up, you know, in the case of an emergency or something like that, that would be a really good thing to have set. And if you don't, here's your homework for the week. All right. So I wanted to keep this short, sweet, and to the point. It's kind of a great idea to have ready. And yes, the whole healthcare thing was on my mind this week, as it's probably on all of our minds. So maybe you want to check into that as well. As always, if you are interested, and if you haven't done so yet, to become a little member of our tribe here, stop over to the website, to BillSkolodowski.com, and sign up for our email newsletter list. It's going to, when you land on the website, it's going to look like this. It's a nice, cool website. Oh, I'm missing. My picture is missing. Oh, no. There I am. That's funny. All right, if you I got confused. I'm sorry. If you land on the website, this is what you're going to see. Click on the big red click me button there in the center and sign up for the newsletter. What that's going to get you is every week it will get you an email, usually on a Sunday afternoon, of the videos that have come out in the past week. Okay, so it'll tell you what the Wednesday video was, this one. It'll tell you what the iPhone Friday video was, and it will also give you, if you want it, the free handout. I'm a classroom teacher, so I think in terms of handouts. It'll give you the handout for that week's iPhone Friday video as well, so you know exactly how to do what it is we talk about on the video. There you go. All right, I'm going to run. Have yourself a great evening, and we'll see you back here for iPhone Friday. Remember, our iPhone Friday series, we're doing iPhone A to Z. And this week we're up to C, and for me, C is for calendar. One of the most important apps on your iPhone to help keep your life organized, to help with that high-tech life. So C is for calendar this week on iPhone Friday. If this has been helpful to you, feel free to share it with friends and colleagues. And if you have questions or comments, leave them wherever you're watching this, Facebook, YouTube, on the blog. I read and respond to all the comments. Thanks again. We'll see you for iPhone Friday.